Our closer look now at a crisis on campus. 60 universities have been put on notice by the Department of Education for how they've handled sexual assaults. Time magazine reports this week that nearly one in five college women have been victims, and the author of that cover story is here, along with a university president taking action after this from Fusion's Alicia Menendez.
At Columbia University this week, an issue coming out of the shadows into the national spotlight.
The nationwide outcry about sexual assault on college campuses.
I was raped by one of my close friends who is also a student at Columbia.
Emma Sulkowitz is one of 23 students at Columbia University, many of whom say they've been victims of sexual assault on campus, filing a federal complaint that says the university has not taken the violence seriously.
I decided to report my case to the school because I decided that something needed to be done so that he would stop attacking women on campus.
What type of justice were you seeking from the administration?
I just wanted him to get off campus.
Last week, someone, who knows who, put graffiti on bathroom walls and flyers across the campus, accusing several students of rape. Columbia has scrubbed the walls and released a statement to ABC News saying they're increasing measures to prevent sexual assault and misconduct and support survivors. It all comes in the middle of a full court press by the White House. Tony West is a member of the president's task force.
I think that when college campuses engage the entire community and send a very strong message that dealing with sexual assault is the collective responsibility of all of us, that's when they're most successful.
One of the biggest challenges for schools, how to define non-consensual sex. Critics question if sometimes the definition universities use is too broad. Right now, the administration estimates that nearly 20% of women have been sexually assaulted in college. It's a stat that's hardly changed in 20 years.
Most colleges vastly underreport sexual assault.
There have been sexual assault cases involving athletes at St. John's, Syracuse.
Rape on USC. Campus when a friend or acquaintance turns out to be the rapist.
Even an article from 1990 about an Ivy League school where victims wrote the names of their attackers on bathroom walls. Kathy Harris was at Brown University then and would become an activist on campus sexual assault.
Whenever there is some national news about campus sexual assault, there becomes some awareness by the schools that they need to do something. As time passes, it's going to blow over and things are going to go just back to how they were. I know this because we were talking about these things 25 years ago. Nothing's changed.
It's too late for Columbia survivor Emma Sulkowitz, but she hopes it might be different for the next student.
I think that universities are in a position to really take the first step and make a change.
For this week, I'm Fusion's Alicia Menendez in New York.
And we are joined now by Eli Capiluto, the president of the University of Kentucky, and Eliza Gray of Time Magazine. And Eliza, let me start with you. You wrote that cover story in Time Magazine this week, and you reach a pretty startling conclusion. You say the truth is for young women, America's campuses are dangerous places. Will this new push by the federal government make a huge difference?
Well, George, you know, I think that we are at a sort of historic moment for this issue because you have a perfect storm of grassroots students at college campuses raising a stink about this, and then you have the vice president who authored the Violence Against Women Act and the president who has daughters and is personally invested in this. And so I do think that you're going to see a spotlight put on this issue that might put a little bit more pressure on colleges to make a change.
President Capiluto, University of Kentucky has been on this for a long time, about yes. 10 years, and been cited as a model by the White House for how you've taken on sexual harassment. What are the best practices that have worked for you?
Sure. Well, first of all, you've got to recognize your problem. 10 years ago, we were one of the first to do a campus-wide climate survey. We understood some of those same horrific numbers that were reported previously. We birthed in an entrepreneurial way interventions that we thought would empower individuals and spread that responsibility collectively to the entire community. Our students, our faculty, our staff, our police force, others that you have to partner with in community to make a difference. And then you've got to stop and reassess, see how effective you are, repeat your surveys, refine, invest, and move forward.
Is there more the federal government should be doing right now?
Well, we have taken this responsibility on. It is a priority for us. One of the things we introduced, a Green Dot program, this is a way that I would say is equivalent to a designated driver in drinking situations, but it's
so the Green Dot who?
The Green Dot program. That program is designed to train college students so that they can be, and we target peer leaders, those who are likely to influence many people on campus. We've trained over 5,000. They know how to recognize a risky situation, intervene, and do it in a creative way.
So they see something, say something on campus. That makes a lot of sense. You know, and Lisa, one of the things you pointed out in your piece that these assaults are carried out by a relatively small group. As you write, most guys are good guys, but the bad ones tend to be repeat offenders. So how do you stop them without stigmatizing everyone else?
Yeah, I think that's really important. You know, I think a lot of times when we think about sexual assault, we think about a he said, she said situation where it was murky. And that certainly does happen. But I do think that, you know, this study that I found showed 6% of males on the University of Massachusetts campus had committed rape, and 75% of them were repeat offenders who had committed an average of 6 rapes each. And so I think what we need to do is sort of speak to the people around them. So when you go to a fraternity party, sort of the training we were just talking about here, when you go to a fraternity party and you see one of your brothers bringing up a girl upstairs who looks too drunk, you know, be creative and spill a drink on him and say, hey man, your car's getting towed, and sort of create a diversion to separate them and keep them safe.
Let's hope it works. Eliza Gray, Mr. Capiluto, thank you both very much.